In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to morph a mobile into a laptop. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll basically use one shape, which we rotate and transform, then add more details to the scene. A technique you can use to morph anything, so stick around till the end. Let's dive in by creating a new comp. We name it Transition. Then we double-click on the rounded rectangle tool to create a shape. We open the rectangle property, disable constraint proportions, and set the size to 200 by 350 pixels. Stroke width 4 pixels. Color a bright cyan. A solid fill color. Let's choose a very dark blue. Let's get the rulers, Command or Control R, and add a guide to the bottom edge. Then we go to 5 frames, let's name the layer screen first. Next we open the position and rotation property, set a keyframe for the position. Then we go to 10 frames and move it down around 30 or 40 frames, and set a rotation keyframe. Then we go to 17 frames and set the rotation to around minus 55 degrees, and move the shape up, and set a keyframe for the path size. We press U to see all the keyframes in the timeline, and go to 24 frames. Set the size to 350 by 550 pixels. Set the rotation to minus 270 degrees. Position it on the guide again. Quite rough still. So, we select the size keyframes, open the graph editor, make sure snap is activated and edit speed graph is selected. Activate constraint proportions to move the curves together. Slow down the beginning and the end. Then we move the points of the green curve down as well. Alright, getting better. Next, we select the rotation keyframes and slow down the beginning quite a bit. And the end? Not as much. Then we select the position keyframes. Speed up the end of the animation as much as possible. Slow down the part before when the shape is flying. Then we slow down the beginning. After dipping down, it shoots up in the air, so we move these points up. Let's see. Not bad. Alright, let's add the keyboard. We duplicate the screen layer, name it keyboard, and move the start point to 24 frames. We press U and remove all keyframes. Then grab the anchor point tool and move the anchor point to the center of the bottom edge. Hold Command or Control for it to snap. Next, we turn it into a 3D layer. Open the rotation and scale property. We set the X rotation to around 55 degrees. And set a keyframe for the rotation and scale. At 27 frames, we set the rotation to around 112 degrees. At 33 frames, it swings back to around 105 degrees. And we set the X value of the scale to around 160% to make the perspective look right. Let's actually adjust the rotation and scale it up a bit more. Awesome. We select the scale keyframes, open the graph editor and adjust the speed graph. Slow down the beginning and end. Then we select the rotation keyframes. The start is pretty fast, the end very smooth. Let's connect the middle part. Maybe like that, let's see. Looking good! The keyboard keys are simple rectangular paths. Let's change the fill color, and we don't want the stroke. Now we add a repeater. Let's adjust the position and transform. X 0, Y around minus 86 pixels. And let's add more copies. Then we duplicate the rectangle 2 times and position the keys on the keyboard. We need to hide the keys before the shape is flipped over. So we open the transform property of all 3 rectangles and set 2 opacity keyframes. Awesome. One thing though, it looks like the fill of my shapes is transparent. Let me quickly check that in the fill property. Yes, that needs to be 100%. The other one as well. Yours should be okay though. That looks right now. To make it more like fake 3D, we copy the screen layer, move it below. Press U and delete all keyframes and move it down a few pixels. We duplicate the keyboard layer, move it one down, move the position a few pixels down, and move the start point to 26 frames. By the way, if you like this video so far, it would be awesome to quickly hit the like button. Thanks very much. Let's add some content to the screens. With no layer selected, we grab the rectangle tool and create a shape inside the phone. Position it. We name it Content Phone. Move it above the screen and quickly change the label color. We need to link the layer to the screen below. Fill color, a dark blue. No stroke. With the layer selected, we grab the pen tool and add some lines. Width, 4 pixels. Then we duplicate the path a few times and position the lines on the screen. Finally, we open the stroke property and set the opacity to 65%. Next, we need to scale the layer up, here at the end. So we go to 17 frames, set a scale keyframe, then go to 24 frames and scale it up. We open the graph editor and adjust the speed curve. Let's see. Too fast here, so let's slow the beginning down a bit. That seems right. Awesome. Now we split the layer at 24 frames. Then we adjust the lines and add some stuff to fill the bigger screen. Hey, let's add some speed lines. At the moment the laptop hits the ground, let's add some blown up dust. Get rid of the guide first. We grab the pen tool and add a curled line. No fill. White stroke. I use a new label color for the lines. Set the start point to 24 frames. Next we add trim paths and animate the start and end. Set a keyframe for the end. Set it to 0. 2 frames later, a keyframe for the start. 2 more frames later, we set the end to 100. 4 frames later, the start to 100. We adjust the end point. Looks good. We duplicate the layer, offset it, and adjust the position slightly. Then we select the two layers, duplicate them. Go to Layer, Transform, select Flip Horizontal. Position them and offset them. Same thing with the other lines. It's simple lines animated with trim paths. Awesome. The laptop keyboard has a purpose. It kind of continues the animation and absorbs the energy of the abrupt stop, which means it naturally belongs to the animation and doesn't disturb. That's the principle. You can morph anything into anything as long as the overall animation feels like one. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. You do want to subscribe for new and original animation and motion design videos every week. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. See you in the next video. Bye!